The Prime Minister, the question is not whether he is useful or useless. The question is to who is he useful? See, everything has some use or the other. Everything has a use, right? The Prime Minister, the question is not whether he is useful or useless. The question is to who is he useful? See, I am useful to farmers of this country. I am useful to poor people in this country. I am useful to ladies and women in this country. I am useful to youngsters in this country. Narendra Modi is useful to two people. He's extremely useful. Because those two people are using the Prime Minister of India to increase their wealth dramatically. And believe me, when the time comes, they will throw him like that. Right? So it is important we have to understand our opponent. He's useless to the poor people. He's very useful to hum do hamare do. A nation is a balance between its institutions. If that balance is disturbed, the nation is disturbed. That is the central idea. What are the institutions that make up the Indian nation? There are elected institutions, Lok Sabha, Vidhan Sabhas, Panchayats. There is the judiciary. There is a supporting free press. These institutions together, they hold the nation in place. And what we have seen over the last 6 years is a systematic attack on all these institutions. Democracy does not die with a bang. It dies slowly. And I'm sad to tell you that democracy in India is dead. It doesn't exist anymore. It is dead because one organization, the RSS, has combined with huge finances to penetrate and disturb and destroy our institutional balance. That is what has happened. There are many, many different manifestations of this. Misuse of sedition law, killing of people, threatening of people. These are all symptoms of the problem. But the problem is that concentration of capital has combined with the organization of the RSS and has disturbed, and I would say actually destroyed, the institutional balance in the country.